Now you know that you are real. Show your friends that you can be. Belong to the same world. Turned on to the same world. Have you heard? Now you know that you are free. Living all your life at ease. Each day has its own ways. A look down life's hallway.
True power is not in division. Our true power is in connection, our collective oneness. And until we realize that, we won't have that power. We won't be who we're meant to be. There's that old saying, divide and conquer. And if that isn't especially true and clear to everyone today, then maybe you need to open your eyes a little bit and pay attention. But it's easy to control people with division, fear, and the idea that we're separate. So if we want to step into our true power and evolve as human beings, we have to quit thinking that we're separate, that you're this and I'm that. I believe this and you believe that. All that stuff has to go. That the color of somebody's skin is actually something that differentiates them. That's like archaic caveman kind of thinking. So, yeah, there's a lot of problems in the world and a lot of hate and a lot of atrocities going on. But these atrocities are caused by the idea that we are divided. Once we realize we're all one, and we step into love, and have no judgment, all those things just dissipate and fade away. So when the news and the media preaches that we're all divided and that we're not together, I suggest you either turn it off or just don't listen to it, because it's just taking your power away and it's not true. We're better than that and we're bigger than that. And when we discover that, we will step into our true power and we will be powerful beings. Are there forces out there that are trying to control us by making us think that we're not together, that we're not powerful as one? I believe there are, but I guess that's another topic. But regardless, we are powerful as one. And as long as we think we're not, and we're nitpicking over petty things like skin color, religion, politics, and all these trivial things in the big picture, then we're going to stay in that space. We'll be easily controlled, whether it's of some nefarious people's agenda or whether it's just us making it so. It doesn't really matter. We have to realize that we are all one. Quit the judgment. Quit the hate. Get out of the boxes. Get into your heart. And live love, not hate, judgment. If we convince ourselves that we're sick, we will be. If we convince ourselves that we're divided, we will be. If we convince ourselves that hatred and judgment and war and all the petty things we fight for are important, then that will be our reality. But if we believe that we're all one, then we will be. And that, to me, is the big answer. The big answer. It's very, very simple. Very, very simple. Get out of that stinking thinking mode. You know, I had a very, very good example, a rudimentary example, but still powerful nonetheless. I was driving down the street and I was in an extremely high vibration, the vibration of love, no judgment, where even your perceived enemies you love. It's a beautiful state to be in. But some stinking thinking started to creep into my mind, and I started judging a person who I perceived as doing me wrong. Slipped back into that. And I found that my vibration just plummeted. And then I was getting into all those lies of judgment and things going around in my head. All the stupidity that we all fall into. Well, I can't make a general statement, but many of us fall into. But then I decided, stop this dialogue. That little negative Nelly on my left shoulder, shut up, I'm not listening to you. I stopped the dialogue and instantly my vibration went up again. It's really as simple as that. You know, when you see somebody and you want to judge them because you don't like what they're wearing, or you don't like what they're doing, or you don't like something about them, we instantly go into judgment and our vibration lowers. But if we simply say, wow, I like that about you, or I like this about you, or I think, you know, something positive about that person, instead of the old go-to negativity that we're all programmed and conditioned to do, the difference is amazing. Difference is amazing. So stop the dialogue. Quit thinking that we're all separated. and just start loving. Start living and feeling with your heart. And let go of the lies of the head. Another crippler is envy. We need to quit being envious of other people's experiences. What they own, what they do, who their girlfriend is. Whatever causes envy in you is a crippler. Because you can't move forward with envy. We have to rejoice. It's a gift. The way we are, the journey we walk, the lessons that we're given the opportunity to learn and work on. These are gifts for our soul progression. And we're here to either address them or not address them. That's our choice, but envy just keeps us in that low vibrational envious state. And so we have to fiercely protect who we are, fiercely protect the lessons that we have to work on or not. But to be envious is just selling ourselves short and you're not doing your work. So envy is a real bad one. And like I said, some of these shortcomings or things that we perceive as shortcomings or things of that nature are literally a gift because it does give us the opportunity to grow. And so we need to protect that and not worry about what other people are doing, what they have, what they experience. None of that stuff matters. What matters is you and what you do with yourself and how you grow within yourself. We are all here to work on our soul agreement from the other side. What we decided that we have to work on, the lessons that we have to undertake to grow. Many of these lessons are really, really hard, brutally hard. But needless to say, these people, the ones we perceive as the dark ones, the evil ones with nefarious agendas, are doing amazing work and waking up a lot of us. Just look what's going on in the world today. Being suppressed as well as it can, but a lot of people are waking up. A lot of people are saying, wait a minute, this is not good, this is not right, I see what's going on. And so for that, it takes something so dark and sinister to jolt us into reality. And so they're needed. There is darkness needed. If we don't see the darkness, how can we know what the light is? So as I said, it's the age-old game of divide and conquer. Because if we ever woke up to our true universal self and realized we were all connected, we would be so powerful. You know, I hate to say it because I know that I will offend people on the other side. But I still, so far, have the right to state my opinion. That is until, you know, somebody decides it goes against the political agenda or the company line or however you want to say it and takes it down, then I guess we don't have freedom of speech. But divide and conquer. How freaking obvious is it, people? Look, this election down south recently, divide and conquer. Political correctness, divide and conquer. Black Lives Matter, divide and conquer. This vaccine, divide and conquer. The mask mandate, divide and conquer. It is so polarizing, so black and white, they are keeping us apart by
any way, any means possible. Because we do have the opportunity to wake up, and they know that. The best way to keep us from doing that is to keep us at odds with each other. There's no gray area in these things anymore. I mean, for Pete's sakes, I know friends down south across the line in the States that got canned or shamed or threatened from their jobs because they supported Trump. That's what in the hell is going on there? Or they said they didn't agree with Black Lives Matter because all lives matter. Well, suddenly you're a racist. It's ridiculous, people. It's time we woke up. We have to wake up to this absurdity. Divide and conquer is how we are easily controlled. And that is what is going on right now. And it's so obvious that I am totally befuddled that people can't see that. Is it because of fear? Is it because they watch the news 24/7 and they actually believe the propaganda? I mean, I don't watch the news, so maybe there is something to that. I don't know, but can you not see what is going on? Can you not see? Can you not see? Divide and conquer.
Now you know how nice it feels. Scatter good seed in the field. Life's ours for the making. Eternity's waiting. Waiting for you. Know that you are real. Show your friends that you and me belong to the same world. Turned on to the same world.